My laboratory has the acronym OPEN, O-P-E-N, and that stands for Orthogonal Physics Enabled Nanophotonics. We are looking for new physical effects, new entities that have not been explored yet.
So here in Science and Engineering Hall, we have a nanofabrication room, and what we do is electron beam lithography, and we use electron beam lithography to fabricate the devices that we want to measure.
Trying to use these nanophotonic devices to design revolutionary computers. So for instance, one example would be we're trying to emulate how our brain works. Our brain has neurons, and we're trying to build optical neurons on a silicon chip platform. It's very exciting.
One of the things I truly appreciate about working in Dr. George's lab has been that a complete project gets assigned to a student, and the student feels that the whole project belongs to them, and they feel more responsible toward it and work harder to achieve those goals.
They are the ones who have new ideas, who test new things which nobody else has tested before.
All of my research projects relate to optics and neurons, whether that's encouraging neurons to grow with the use of light or modeling neurons with light.
My name is Suresh Subramaniam. I am the chair of the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. I'm also the director of the Lab for Intelligent Networking and Computing, also known as LINC.
One of the most important topics that we work on is security. One of the ways that we look at these types of security problems is to understand what can adversaries do? How can we stop adversaries from taking advantage of the information that's stored in our computers? Number three is, how do we effectively build a secure processor that would not just prevent but defeat those adversaries if they were to intrude into our systems?
My research in the area, which is called adaptive signal processing, that really means that you have many different type of observations, like from camera, from microphone, measurement on electrical quantities from wires, and based on that, what you measure, you extract information that can be used in different applications.
The benefit of doing this in Washington, D.C. is that we are so close to many of the federal agencies that fund the research that supports these students, specifically the National Science Foundation, the Army Research Lab, the Naval Research Lab, and the Department of Defense. That kind of helps the students to connect with these kinds of funding agencies.
Given that we're in the nation's capital, we have the opportunity to interact with a lot of top researchers, educators, and even policymakers from all over the world.